Hello, everyone. I'm Jeff Schneider. I do product management for Dell PowerMax. I'm joined here today by my colleague, Tom O'Neill.
Hi, everybody. I'm Tom O'Neill from the PowerMax product management team, and we're here as part of the Architecture Matters series. I tend to focus more on the software side of the house, and Jeff tends to focus more on the hardware side of the house. So, Jeff, what do you see as some of the key PowerMax differentiators?
Well, we're going to talk today about mission-critical applications and how the PowerMax architecture is ideally suited for mission-critical applications. Let's start with, what is mission-critical? What does that mean? Mission-critical operations are those things that businesses and governments and stock markets that must be available all the time. The data must be available all the time. The whole system must be running all the time, always available, never go down. In addition, the data itself must be protected and secure. These mission-critical applications exist or run in all kinds of verticals, in banks, stock exchanges, hospitals, anywhere medical records are used, airline reservation systems. There's lots of examples across all kinds of businesses and governments. Some of the applications that are important to this are database applications like Oracle or SAP HANA, Salesforce, and of course, for medical records, there's Epic, there's others as well. So it's a very important function for business and governments, and the PowerMax architecture is particularly well suited for it.
All right, well, that's great, Jeff. Can you talk a bit more about the PowerMax architecture?
Sure, Tom. The PowerMax architecture is designed for mission-critical applications. First of all, it can scale. PowerMax can scale up and it can scale out. It can scale up to 20 petabytes of effective capacity in one array. It can scale from 2 to 16 nodes. And we can scale the media and the compute independently because of the architecture. The architecture is built around a dynamic NVMe fabric. It's an InfiniBand-based, very high-speed fabric that is the core of the system. There's a principle that we've designed the architecture around that we call any-to-any. That is that any I/O can be serviced by any compute node, and that compute node can access any device on any drive in the system. So that both gives it a lot of flexibility. It also gives it some resiliency, because if there was some event, say a node becomes unavailable for some reason or a node goes down, other nodes can handle the load and keep it running. Some competitive systems have a concept of LUN ownership, where the devices that the customer is using, the LUNs, logical units, are assigned to particular compute nodes. In that case, if there's a node unavailability or a node failure, you have to make a configuration change to continue to service that I/O. PowerMax doesn't have that problem. It's highly reliable all the time. The architecture is also designed for high availability. There is redundancy all the way through the architecture. The power system, the data paths, the control paths, there really are no single points of failure in a PowerMax. It's also highly resilient. PowerMax is designed to continue running even in some exceptional situations. For example, PowerMax can tolerate a high temperature excursion. PowerMax can tolerate up to 50 degrees C temperature excursion and continue running, which is unusual, unique in the industry and unique to PowerMax to be able to withstand those kind of conditions. So it's a great architecture for mission critical applications. So let's switch gears a little bit. And hey, Tom, can you tell us some about the data services on PowerMax?
Sure, thanks, Jeff. So, you know, PowerMax is the clear leader in software data services. You know, no one out there can do what we can do. You know, I think one interesting subtle feature that we don't really talk about much is that we can upgrade our boxes in under 6 seconds. This allows customers to be able to very quickly take advantage of new features without having any performance or downtime during the upgrade. Our scalability on PowerMax, I think as many people know, is massive. You know, we can support 64,000 devices, which is industry leading, and we can do that with every single feature on the array. So, you know, some competitive arrays, you know, if you want to do data reduction, you can only do it on X number of devices. Snapshots might be Y number of devices. We can do all of our features across all of the devices on an array. So if you want to consolidate and put a lot of applications on a PowerMax, we can do that. Another interesting, you know, great data protection feature is that we support over 1,000 snapshots for every one of these devices. So when you multiply that together, you know, we can take up to 65 million snapshots on any array. This is no one else in the industry can do that. We are the clear industry leader. And we have customers that push us in all of these areas. You know, we have customers that run, you know, almost 64,000 devices on their array, so it's a very big box. We also have customers that take tens of millions of snapshots, you know, for data protection. You know, our snapshots are also can also be secure if you want. We have a concept that we call a secure snapshot. And what a secure snapshot is, it's a snapshot that the user sets a time limit on how long they want to keep the snapshot around for, and no one within the IT department can delete that snapshot. You know, it's really meant to help protect against ransomware attacks and even internal threats. You know, so those are super secure and really gotten heavily used over the last couple of years by our customer base. This would lead into a sort of a broader security discussion that we don't have time for today. We'll do it in another session. So Jeff, one differentiated feature on PowerMax that customers love is data reduction. Could you tell us more about it?
Sure. PowerMax data reduction is a key feature of the architecture and a key differentiator, for the product. PowerMax data reduction uses compression and deduplication algorithms to reduce the data. And one particular attribute of it is something we call activity-based compression. Activity-based compression is there's basically an AI engine built into PowerMax that looks at the customer's workloads and looks at the customer's usage of the system, and it keeps the most active data uncompressed. So therefore, when you're accessing that data, you don't have to be decompressing it all the time. If the box starts to fill up, if you have a very full array, it will compress everything to make sure you get full use of all the capacity in the array. But usually there's space on the box and it'll leave the most active data uncompressed. This technology lets us offer an industry-leading 5-to-1 data reduction guarantee. And it also provides something really important for mission-critical applications. It provides consistent high performance using data reduction, or frankly not. You have control over it by storage group. So we're going to turn it back over to Tom now. Tom, can you talk some about how PowerMax delivers business continuity and disaster recovery to our customers?
Sure. Thanks, Jeff. So PowerMax is the gold standard for business continuity and disaster recovery. The PowerMax team invented replication, you know, a few decades ago and has been at it for quite some time. So the team has seen every possible issue a customer could run into in their environment. You know, so we support really three types of replication. We support synchronous rep, asynchronous rep, and active-active, which we call metro. We can do this over, you know, two site scenarios, three site scenarios, or even four site scenarios. You know, what we've seen recently is a technology that we call SmartDR has become very popular. SmartDR is a three array solution that's in two sites. The one site is you'll have an active-active metro cluster, we call it, within two arrays. It provides, you know, active-active replication within a site. And then you'll have an asynchronous connection to a third array, which is at least, say, 100 kilometers away. It's become very popular in smaller countries, particularly in Europe, where, you know, some of their regulations say that they need to keep their data within the boundaries of the country. So a bank, for instance, will run, you know, an active-active metro pair at their, you know, main headquarters or their main data center, and they'll have a third array as far in the country as they can get it away from the, you know, from the capital, say, just in case something ever happens in the capital, so they can protect all of the customer's data. You know, in addition to SmartDR, we've been getting a lot of increasing requests for foresight. It's become a very popular recent ask from a lot of customers. And really what that is it's two pairs of arrays where one set of the arrays is either running metro or synchronous replication, and they're both asynchronous distance away. So in summary, PowerMax is the gold standard in replication and data services. Jeff, as we're going to wrap up this session, do you have anything else that you'd like to add?
I would just add that PowerMax is the industry leader in high-end mission-critical storage. Folks, I hope you're enjoying the Architecture Matters series. Thanks for watching.
Thank you.